Good day, fellas. I hope you are ready for your daily dose of skill, and today we are going to play with a Kunze Panzer. And oh boys, I can tell you one thing, I can't stand this vehicle. I had my warming up rounds and I performed like professional. For some reason, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, I can't stand this tank. I love tier 9s in general, I truly do. There is so many beautiful tanks in the game and everything, but this vehicle is just simply not my style, not my cup of tea, and I just can't say anything good about it. Anyways, I am quite curious to figure out what is your opinion about this tank. Do you like it? Do you hate it? So feel free to share that with us in the comment section down below, and I will try to make it work. So, what is so damn special about the Kunze Panzer? Well, it is a tier 9 tank which has -15 degrees of the gun depression, by the way, the biggest and the best gun depression in the world of tanks, at least in the higher tiers, not counting those tier 1, tier 2 tanks which have minus 25, right? Or minus 20, doesn't really matter. So yeah, so this is a good thing. What is bad thing? In my humble opinion, this tank is completely misplayed with a siege mode, because whenever you are going to the siege mode, your DPM is decreasing because your reload is increasing, which doesn't make any sense, plus you are losing speed, which is kind of understandable, and you are getting the very, very good gun handling, but it's just too much of a hustle, if that makes sense. I can tell you one thing. What do I think? What is the biggest problem? Leopata is better. Leopata has better gun handling. Leopata has more alpha damage. Leopata having the same speed pretty much. There is no need for Kunze to play with a Kunze Panzer, if that makes sense, right? So this is my opinion, and let's try to make it work. I truly want to make this tank work, and I want to finish with a 4,000, 5,000, 6,000 combined session. But for that, we need to be very, very lucky, and I need to be ideal. Okay. So the first things first, I want to punish this black dog. It is very important. And this black dog should go like this. Okay. Hi. That's one. Can we get another one? No, we cannot. I know I am in the open field against the bushwankers which are sitting here. I am very, very well aware of that, fellas. I know exactly what we are doing here, and I know what kind of risk we are taking. Now the question is, this Progetto will try to peek here sideways. Oh yes, he will. I don't really think reaction was ideal from my side, so I don't really think I can be very very sad about missing this shot. Let's be real. Okay, so what do we have? We have an actually decent start from this game. Oh, okay, I see what you are doing. We have a decent start. Pretty much our team has everything, I would say. Our team has everything. We are controlling the hill. We are controlling this side. In other words, I have a feeling enemies are going to get punished for their stupidity. Let's put that in this way. Anyways, Progetto in the open field. Obviously, we are going for Progetto. I might get spotted. Doesn't really change anything. Ah, it changes something. I forgot to say one more thing about this vehicle. This tank do not have absolutely any armor whatsoever. Like, it is the same thing if you would play with a light tank or you are playing with this vehicle, right? And you might think, but skill, the gun depression is absolutely amazing. Yeah, gun depression is absolutely amazing. I agree with you 100%. But the fact you are losing DPM is just beyond me. I mean, usually siege mode is giving DPM, right? You have depression, you have DPM. Hip hip hooray, everything is fine. But in this kind of situation, unfortunately, things are looking a bit different. But that's fine, let it be. Anyways, we are not going to give up. We will try to get as much use as we physically and possibly can, right? This is going to be our goal for this game and overall for this video. And I can tell you one very, very simple thing, fellas. There is some people which loves this vehicle, but in the same time there is some people which loves LOL tractor or whatever. That was quite stupid pick by me, not gonna lie. And I obviously cannot complain about this. And it doesn't make LOL tractor is the best vehicle in the game. Or someone can like tanks like Paton Kier. I like Paton Kier. And it doesn't mean Paton Kier is decent vehicle or this is the tank. Oh yes, every single person should get this vehicle. Not at all. Anyways, you get the point what I am saying. So yeah, I'm not very happy with this performance. I'm not happy with this game. So far, everything is looking very, very, very weak for our performance, right? We have done 3 shots pretty much. We spotted 1,000. And believe me, I am trying to break enemy defense. I am trying to do that. I am trying to spot people which are playing in the back, like this Škoda. And in the same time, obviously, we are trying to get as much use as we can from blind firing Arta, or alternatively trying to hit this Progetto, which is sitting somewhere, probably here. Mm-hmm. Patience. Trying to go for a blind shot. Unfortunately, it is not working. I don't know how I can get more involved here. I just simply don't. I just don't know how I could get more involved. Do they have Bushwanker apart Progetto? No, they don't. Okay, we can try to get involved like this. Trying to hit this guy. Beautiful hit. I am super happy about this. Excellent. Now the question is, how we can get involved against the T95? There is one way how we can do the things. First of all, we are waiting until the Škoda will peak. Whoa, 1 HP. So we are waiting until the Škoda will peak. If Škoda is not going to peak. Oh, I can whistle Škoda. If the Škoda is not planning to peak, we are going to try to beat the living hell out of the T95 for obvious reasons, right? And we are trying to save our score. Very, very, very hardcore game. Extremely hard battle overall. Extremely hard battle. Hop. Hop, hop, and, well, at least my corpse is having a great time. Skill, what do you mean your corpse is having a great time? Well, you see, my corpse is outplaying this T95. Fellas, this is a solid banana out of 10. It was a gentle slide, and we pretty much destroyed him fully, although it's not our damage. And this is kind of silly thing. I think Wargaming should fix this, and I think the damage should belong to you if you are dying on top of the tank, right? But once again, that's only me. Anyways, first battle while recording, 2,200 damage, 1,300 assisting damage. Not great performance, not great game, but this is with what we need to live with. And let's see, maybe we have some blind shots on Arta. There is a tiny chance we blind shot at Arta before, but once again, everything is depending on the luck, I would say. So let's see. No blind shots whatsoever. We had one shot, one kill, one damage. Beautiful, and this is how we are finishing everything. We are second by experience, third by the damage, and once again, this is completely normal performance for me with this vehicle. And usually, if I would play with E50, I would say, yeah, fellas, this is not the great game and everything. With the Kunze, I am okay. That's all right, battle. That's how low of the expectations I have for a Kunze and for myself while playing with this tank. It's just bad. This is my opinion. And in the same time, I cannot wait, fellas, to read your comments down below. What do you think about this vehicle yourself? Do you think it is a great tank, or do you think the tank is not so great? I am very, very curious. Also comparing that to the other medium tanks like Leopata, E50, or anything else, actually. So, yeah. Okay, so what do we have? We have counter-attack. or encounter battle, I suppose to say. One base, two teams. What is happening in my head? I am trying to make a decision, what do I want to do? Do I want to go into the bush and spot? Answer is no, because of the light tanks. Do I want to go here and try to use gun depression? I definitely could do that, but base is here. And I need to be close to the base just to decap it. This is the thing. Meanwhile, our Centurion is yelling, manipulated game, don't pay. Fellas, I have a feeling someone was watching our videos lately. What do you think? What do you think? Okay, that's quite clear. Enemies are thinking about making pressure like this, and in fact, they are making pressure like this. We know they have some light in the bush for obvious reasons. That's what we know. Can I craft the nice angle for this gentleman? And we have most of our forces here. I don't want to talk too much yet, but I have a feeling. I have a feeling we are going to have a huge trouble here. But like humongous trouble. We have some problems, fellas. We truly do. T95 just fired. Listen, we need to escape. We are going to lose this game by the huge margin, at least by the looks of it. At least by the looks of it. How we can kill them? T95 is extremely dangerous tank for us, for obvious reasons, right? It is very dangerous, Mother Trucker. Okay. He is thinking about being involved here. Boom. Okay, look, we are going to start beating the living crap of him with the hits. This is only one way how we can do this. I mean, we could track him and everything, but I don't really think we are going to get enough use of all this. Now T95 will go with a blind shot soon, probably, especially when the sixth sense will start working. Watch this, 3, 2, 1, blind shot. When we have this out of the way, we can actually beat the living crap out of this gentleman, I would say. Okay, what to do next? What to do next? What to do next? What to do next? I would say, we kind of want to defend our projector, I would say our base from the people which is trying to get a bit more involved like this. So now we are going to get the siege mode, beautiful, leaving the siege mode because this is a very, very disgusting system, going into the siege mode, hitting the guys sideways, loading the full gold, leaving the siege mode, yeah, so much unnecessary shit, going into the siege mode, hitting the guy, leaving the siege mode, because I am not losing DPM in this way, going into the siege mode, hitting the guy, going out of the siege mode. I mean, holy bananas from Banana Land. You can say whatever you want, but whoever made this tank and they thought, oh, it's going to be unique because we are going to remove DPM from the vehicle whenever it is in the siege mode, I think this is just ridiculous. I mean, obviously, I get the point. It is not a premium tank, so Wargaming doesn't need to make it a good vehicle, right? At least this is my understanding. So yeah, so such a hustle to play with this tank. Insanity. So if I can recommend something, I can probably recommend not to get this vehicle for battle pass points, I would say think twice before getting this vehicle for yourself for battle pass points. Okay. Wait,
relax, take it easy. We have all time in the world of tanks. We are going to go like this now, trying to find a decent angle, and T95 is bad aim by me. Okay, so once again, I would love to say we could do something else here, my friends, but honestly, with all respect, I don't really think we can. Unfortunately, but obviously we do not really have any armor whatsoever. And we don't really, we can't do absolutely anything. 5 to 15, this is what we have. It is just making my heart to bleed, fellas. I don't know what I supposed to say. Believe me, I don't like shit-talking vehicles. This is not my intention unless tanks are very, very, very bad. And more I play with this vehicle, more I am losing my my positivity is just evaporating, if I can say so, right? Obviously, I don't really want to influence your decision what you want to... do you like this vehicle or you don't like this vehicle, but this is how I feel like. And if I would say... I would feel very, very bad with myself if I would say, well, this tank is very nice. Or this tank is the best tank in the world of tanks. I wouldn't be myself. And once again, I can't wait to read the comment section down below what you have to say about this vehicle. Anyways, two battles done in 15 minutes. World of Tanks, right? So let's see. Can we power grind this video and get a 4 minutes battle? Because if so, we are going to finish today's video under 20 minutes. Obviously, I am messing with you and I... Ooh, God damn it. Fellas, maybe I need to ask more slower games. What do you think? Look at this. We have Kampinovka. Okay. If this is not a high scoring map for this tank, I don't know what is. In this battle, I want to get like as a bare minimum 7,000 combined. I'm not joking, fellas. I want 7,000 combined in this battle. That's how much I want. But in the same time, it doesn't mean we are going to get it. So there is a couple of ways how we can play this battle. Option number one is to play in one line somewhere here. Option number two is to play here. Option number three is to play here. Although here and here you can move as much as you want. And the fourth option is to play on top of the hill, which I don't like nowadays. Because you can only... Unfortunately, but on the top of the hill you can... you can only hold. Making pressure nowadays, it is pretty much impossible, or it is not great. Okay. We are checking the things and we are sitting in the typical bush. And this bush for me became typical bush because usually you are countering... usually you are countering the person which is getting there. And my mission is to go for a blind shots left, right and center. So yeah. Okay, our guys are getting spotted. Listen, light tank is here. Light tank is here. Okay, T-55 is there. Good, good, good. This is not excellent. This is not excellent, my friends. This is truly not excellent. They have a light tank which is doing a great job. Extremely great job, fellas. Enemy light tank is trying to... Well, he is spotting 1-2 line. The question is where exactly he is. This is the question. And to counter this mother trucker, it is going to be insanely hard, I would say. Mm-hmm. Okay. The best thing what we could do in this battle is to be patient and to sit in this bush. Skill, why sitting in this bush is so damn good? Well, sitting in this bush is pretty damn good because we can spot people which are peeking in the middle. And we can spot someone who is trying to shoot from here. Once again, I'm very, very well aware of those guys losing HP, and they lost HP for a light tank which is somewhere here. Can I counter this light tank? If I am going to be involved like this, I am going to be dead meat. There is nothing what we can do. There is two Artas which are sitting there and one Arta which was too lazy to relocate and sitting in the spawn. So far it's not looking good. Our team is planning and trying to make pressure through the hill, and it is unpushable. If you are making pressure through the hill, more likely you are going to get farmed by the gentlemen which are playing in the middle. So you cannot make pressure here. It's a very important thing to say. And plus on top of that, there is three Artas. Hard one. Very hard game. I am not, like I said before, I'm not going to be involved whatsoever. I am not going to make any pressure whatsoever because it's just simply not worth it. If I will go in front, I'm going to be dead by the Artas or alternatively by the bush sniper schnitzel. So yeah. Patience. I would still take this game any day, any time compared to 15-1, right? Situation. Okay, good. Now our guys might. I repeat, our guys might punish him. Or not. I have 53 average penetration. If you are wondering what we are trying to do here, we are trying to make sure this light tank will be dead. And I cannot let this person escape from here. It is very, very important thing to say. E100 is trying over peak. I know, I'm very, very well aware of that. I know, fellas, I know. This light tank is a huge pain in the ass. And now we need to figure out where this gentleman is sitting at. I really doubt this guy escaped. So now we need to... Bam. Good. Worth it. Worth it. Even though we lost 600 HP, I do not really think we made a humongous mistake. I truly don't think we made a huge mistake here. And from now on, we will try to beat the living crap out of the person which is sitting here. They should have the T-55A here. There is no other way, right? There is no other way. Maybe he is sitting somewhere here in the lower part, but still, I kind of doubt it. Going for another blind shot? Okay. How the things will look like now? If this 13... If this 3090 is smart, what this mother trucker is doing? I hate this tank gun handling. What this guy is doing here, slowly but surely trying to make a bit of pressure like this. I would not act surprised if he is doing exactly that. Was a 55, I can see him, he saw me. I am paying a huge attention what people in the middle are doing here. Because this is our game. This is how we need to play this battle. Need to be very, very patient, and we need to sit in the bush while spotting people which are overpeaking like this. Okay, roger that. I thought I am not going to get outspotted, but as you can see, I was wrong. Nothing what I can change about that though. Good. Do I want to completely escape from here? This is now the other question. Do I want to completely escape from here? Char footer going up, char footer going up, char footer going up, char footer going up. We are spotting char footer, and unfortunately we are not having a single soul which is hitting him. I would love to say something nice, but once again, in this battle, it doesn't really matter with what kind of tank we would play. The situation would be still the same, in my humble opinion. Situation would still be the same. Oh, is it only me or this gentleman is trying to blind fire us? Because it looks like it is the case. I am spotted. Okay, from now on, light tank is sitting here. From now on, light tank is sitting somewhere here, fellas. I'm not joking. Good luck out playing that light tank. How we could get spotted, there is only one way. The thing is, when light tank is pushing like this, right? What is happening? You are getting spotted. And once again, MX1390, he's a very, very, very good tank, light tank player. You can clearly see that. And he's already playing probably here, or he's even making pressure like this. So yeah, it's a matter of the time until our team will lose. Pay attention where this guy will get spotted. Like I said, you see? I knew exactly what he is doing here. I knew that, fellas. And now this is a high scoring ticket for this gentleman, or it was high scoring ticket until he died. Well, hashtag never lucky. Okay, let's teleport into the end of this battle. Not happy with my 4,500. It could be so much better, but once again, we got outplayed by the light, and the light tank have definitely advantage in this. Anyways, let's go. And we are back, fellas. Not a big surprise we are losing this game. It was completely understandable, and once again, kudos to the enemy light tank, which did absolutely amazing stuff here. He made pressure. He was super aggressive, and he cleared 1-2 line pretty much mostly. And it was very, very good game. Fellas, having a light tank which is capable of doing stuff like this is absolutely amazing. Anyways, in the same time, we have only 1,300 damage, but 5,400 assisting damage. So we had some blind damage, which is very, very nice. And yeah, speaking about the light tank, he spotted 2,700. Okay, I thought he actually going to spot more. So who did the most spotting? Emil, VZ, obviously Artas did some heavy lifting. Interesting. Very, very interesting. Anyways, this is the score which we have, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen. And after three games, we finished everything with a 4,700 combined and 33% win ratio. I don't know what I can say more. It's not my favorite tank. I don't really like this vehicle, and now I can't wait until you will share your opinion in the comment section down below, and you will say what do you think about this tank in general. Thank you very much for watching. That was your daily dose of skill, and skill is out for today. See you tomorrow. Peace.